torch's going out.
No, it's not. It's going to run out soon.
She hasn't got much time.
She's too slow.
It's not going to burn out.
The darkness will come again.
Lighting the torch. It's not gonna help her.
She's lighting the fire.
Darkness. Do you think you can keep away from the shadows if you light the torch? You're wrong.
Let's go.
without your light. Take the torch and move. She has it.
She did it. She's done it. Well done.
And this place, it reminds her of the isolating, suffocating darkness that she lived through as a young girl. Imprisoned in her room at night, the faces in the dark, coming through the walls. She once thought everyone could see them. I mean, that's what children say all the time, isn't it? That there are monsters in the dark. By the time she realized that only she could see them, her father, Zinbel, could see the monster in her.
She'll have to go under.
She can't.
She has to.
She can't.
The torch will go out.
Don't. Let the torch go out.
There's a light in the distance.
She has
she
to
can
go
do
out.
It.
She can't do it.
No. The light's gone out. Run. Run. Get through it as quick as you can. The panic is
run.
You killed us. Rian the Dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rian would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rian reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rian go in search of Fafnir.
They told me she escaped the darkness, that she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here?
The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all who owned it. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
Why did you leave me? spreading. Father's keeping me away from the others. Away from Tilly. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here. I'm going to find Tilly.
She knows the beast is there.
He's always
watching you.
You're never safe from him.
You can feel him. She needs to find him.
She's found it.
She lost it, and she has to find it. The torch alight.
Not good. death.
You killed her.
Fight.
Zinbel was trying to save her from the darkness.
Although Sigurd kills the dragon, Rian wants to keep Fafnir's gold all for himself. Rian also wants the strength and wisdom of the dragon, so he drinks its blood and asks Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart for him. Sigurd does so, but when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby.
The beast has the head.
Got the head. She will be trapped.
The beast has the head and he's using it.
Once she gets down there, she'll never come out. It's luring her down.
The darkness will take her like it took her mother.
Deeper. The beast knows. The beast knows exactly.
She's
falling for it.
She falls for their tricks every time.
Plays into his hands.
Sigurd's newfound power lets him hear the birds speak. And they say, Sigurd should eat the heart himself. Rian wants Fafnir's gold. Kills Rian, eats Fafnir's roasted heart, and takes Fafnir's treasure. And he embarks on a new quest. To ride to Hinderfell and find Brynhild, the Valkyrie.
Thank you.
What's she doing?
She's lighting a fire.
She's making a fire.
She's got light on the other side.
She'll be safe.
What's her plan?
What's she thinking?
How's she going to get there?
Help but think of him. A tender guiding flame in a world so black. The longer it burned, the more she convinced herself that there was nothing beyond its reach. How little separates us from what we fear.
No fear would ever reach her. But like me, Sigurd is fearless and passes through the flames just as I did. Wakes the sleeping warrior girl. She teaches him the secret wisdom of runes, namely victory runes, ship runes, runes for persuasion, runes for truth, runes for healing and health, runes for perception and power. Like Sigurd, the greatest young warrior of the North, you must learn the secrets of the runes to fight amongst the gods in hell.
Keep the torch up. Keep the torch up. Keep the light.
Come back.
You're not taking it from me.
I've warned you, Senua. I can smell your
blood. No!
You betrayed your gods.
I am leaving with him.
You turned your back on me. That is why Dillian will rot in hell.
People think of evil as an unnatural, invisible force, and so invoke the gods for protection. But evil can come from the hand behind the gods. A familiar hand, cold and cruel. He tried to fix her with his rituals, kept her trapped in that hole. She couldn't say which was worse. The darkness. Or the monster that her father had become. She couldn't fight them both. And so she left. Headed for the one ray of light that shone down on her. If she had stayed, she wouldn't have survived. Maybe Dillian would still be alive.
I am so sorry, my love.
She will save his soul. Even if this time she can't save her own.
Forgive me, Senua. I know you have no reason to trust me anymore.
Shut up. Listen.
But believe this. It was my mission to make you hate. To hate the darkness with a passion so great it would focus your mind on this quest. Without it,
listen.
I He wanted to protect you from the truth that would have destroyed you a long time ago. But you have conquered your darkness at every turn. You deserve to see behind the veil of darkness.
And take me to the mountain.
To trust
as deep as we can go.
I won't stand in the